Sunday, January 26th, couple of fouilles in Port-au-Prince, Haiti. There's excitement in the air. As we were cooking breakfast this morning, I was called to this place right here and found, entering through that gate right behind me, four U.S. military men, 82nd Airborne Division. They were looking for a place to set up a clinic with 40 doctors, and I told them one just left here. Meanwhile, another military person came in and said they found another location that would be more suitable. So we're going to Rue Alibin, I believe, to visit them. Kijan Yodi?
Alibin.
Alibin. Rue Alibin. Another guy came in, communications. He had a radio, I guess, and he was talking with Pastor Josuè. And he said, you'll see all the military vehicles and whatnot, so we're just going to go check them out and see what they're doing. I guess that we were told the military goes out at night and looks for a place, and then they bring the medics, etc., the next day and set it up. So it's just day by day, move to a new location each day. The guys we talked to had been here 2 weeks already, and they've been camping out at the university, I guess. So it's going to be fun. Hi, who are we speaking with?
Efren Garcia, Specialist Garcia.
What do you specialize in?
I'm a Cav Scout, 19 Delta from Fort Bragg, North Carolina. We're providing medical and medicine for the people around here. I've been around about 8 days now.
8 days. Where are you staying?
At the golf course on the tennis court.
Whoa.
Sleeping on the tennis court.
You got a hole in one yet?
Oh, no. Ain't got time for that. They were handing food and water out to the locals up there as well.
And you're with the 82nd Airborne Division, so did you parachute in?
Oh, no. I wish.
So this is the first morning that you've had the clinic here.
Yeah, we drive around and we stop in neighborhoods that look like they need help. And we'll set up and provide security for the medical teams that go inside.
Oh, okay. And the medical team is military as well?
They are civilians, American civilians.
Oh, wow. Is there a certain group that they're with?
There's like DMAT that's out here and a couple other organizations that we bring along with us.
Okay, cool. Thanks for speaking with us, Efren.
No problem.
We decided, actually I heard a few days ago that there's a clinic in the football stadium, so we made our way down here and we're going to go check out what's happening in the clinic behind me, see what they're up to, see if there's some way I could help out in the city. It's hard work, huh?
It's very hard. We've been up since 6. We had a couple of pancakes, little ones, and nothing since then. I'm thirsty and I'm tired. But
what's your name?
I'm Vincent Hayes. I'm from Washington, D.C. area.
And what group are you with?
Heart to Heart International. It's a small volunteer organization. We're all volunteers. We all pay our own way here. And we're grassroots. Most of us here are doctors. There's some nurses as well. We come immediately during the disaster, and our plan is to set up clinics on an ongoing basis. We'll be here for years. We try to get things established, not only medical help, we'll have some psychiatric help here eventually, help with schools, things like that. So we're grassroots and we try and build from the bottom up.
How many people do you think you're seeing each day?
That's a good question. How many a day? David, the longest of 200 maybe?
Probably.
About 200 more?
More than 200.
Yeah. 250 people at this one spot. But we have teams in other parts of the country, in Leogon, other parts of the city.
Yeah.
So in a day, our team could see maybe 1,000 people.
Yeah.
Are you seeing mainly injuries from the earthquake or other stuff?
The first week and a half to 10 days that we've been here, we've seen mostly injury from earthquakes. Now we're starting to see things related to anxiety, chronic problems, high blood pressure, diabetes. But unfortunately, we don't really have a way to treat a lot of that stuff right now. Hopefully, we'll move on to that as well. We're seeing very bad injuries, a lot of infections. We're starting to see some diarrheal diseases as well in children. We've had some dehydrated babies that we had to send to the hospital, things like that.
Okay, well, I'll let you guys get back to
it. Okay, thanks very much. Good luck to you, too.
Thank you.
So there you have it. They don't need anybody except for really medical help. And we see behind us and the whole football field, just a tent city. People have set up camp. They're living there. I don't know if they view it as permanent, but lots of their houses probably don't even exist anymore. I would imagine lots of these people were renters, but, you know, with so many other places destroyed too, it would be hard for them to find available places to live. I guess it remains to be seen whether the populace of Port-au-Prince and other cities that were affected will stay in the city or relocate to the countryside. January 27th, we went to the hospital and found the 82nd Airborne Division again. They're providing protection for a medical clinic there that's been there since the 19th. But they don't need any help either there. They're actually here trying to not just let as minimum as people inside as possible because they have had a problem with looting. So we came down to check out the palace, and all in front of the presidential palace, which you can see behind me, looks pretty destroyed, but just giant tent city all around here. There's people living here, commerce going on, kind of life is normal, but in the streets.
Samson, Leon, and Chase.